Hey, thanks for watching this video. There's more at Embark Online. You can tweet me, and there is the pie guy. All right, this is fourth grade, module 7, lesson 4. And in this lesson, students are going to be solving comparison problems involving measurement. So let's get started. So here it says that Sandy took the train to New York City and the trip took 3 hours. Jackie took the bus, which took twice as long. How many minutes did Jackie's trip take? All right, so now let's go back and let's read. Okay, so it says Sandy took the train and the trip took 3 hours. All right, so let's draw Sandy's trip. So Sandy, her trip took 3 hours. So I'm going to draw a block and have that block represent 3 hours. Now it says Jackie took the bus, which took twice as long. So Jackie, how do you spell it? It's J-A-C-K-I-E. Jackie, now her bar needs to be twice as long. So it's going to be one of Sandy's and another of Sandy's. So you see Jackie's is twice as long. So first off, if this was 3 hours, that means this is 3 hours. And this is also 3. So Jackie has a total of 6 hours. So Jackie's trip took 6 hours. But the big question is, how many minutes did Jackie's trip take? So we need to take that 6 hours. Each hour is 60 minutes. So 6 times 60 is 360 minutes. So Jackie's trip is right there, 360 minutes. So we've got Colton, and Colton's puppy weighed 3 pounds, 8 ounces at birth. The vet weighed the puppy again at 6 months, and the puppy weighed 7 pounds. And the big question is, how many ounces did the puppy gain? So a couple of ways to do this. I'm going to put it on a number line because I think that's going to be kind of cool. So if we think about a number line, and if I just arbitrarily put 3 pounds, 8 ounces right there. So 3 pounds, 8 ounces right there. And we want to put, let's put 7 pounds right here. So what we want to do is we want to figure out the distance from here to here. What do we have to add to 3 pounds, 8 ounces to get up to 7 pounds? All right. Well, the next pound, the even pounds, is 4 pounds. All right. So what do we have to do to get from 3 pounds, 8 ounces to 4 pounds? Well, we have to add 8 ounces because there's 16 ounces in a pound. So if we have 3 pounds, 8 ounces, adding 8 more ounces, that gives us to 4 pounds. Now, what do we need to do to go from 4 pounds to 7 pounds? Well, that's pretty straightforward. That's just 3 more pounds. So what do we have to add? How much did Colton's puppy weigh from the beginning to the end? I mean, how much did it grow from the beginning to the end? Well, we can see it grew 3 pounds, 8 ounces. So it grew 3 pounds, 8 ounces. But the question is saying, how many ounces did the puppy gain? See right there, that's the key thing. How many ounces did the puppy gain? So we have to convert 3 pounds into ounces. Well, times by 16, because each pound is 16 ounces. So that gives us 48 ounces plus the other 8 ounces. So that's 56 ounces altogether. So Colton's puppy gained 56 56 ounces. So here we've got Jessie, and she bought a 2-liter bottle of juice. Her sister drank, so that's a 2-liter bottle. Her sister drank 650 milliliters. How many milliliters are left in the bottle? So here's our bottle. And that's 2 liters. 2 liters. Well, we need to remember that 2 liters is equal to 2,000 milliliters. Because each liter, 1 liter, is 1,000 milliliters. In fact, that's the whole point of the phrase milliliters. Milli means thousandths. So 2 liters is 2,000 milliliters, but the sister drank 650 of those 2,000 milliliters. So we've got 2,000, subtract 650. Gives us 1,300 milliliters left over. So that's how much is still left in the bottle. And the last one, a box weighs 8 ounces, right here. A shipment of boxes weighs 7 pounds. How many boxes are in the shipment? So the idea is saying, okay, if a box weighs 8 ounces, and a shipment of these boxes weighs 7 pounds, how many boxes are in the shipment? Well, we need to remember that in 1 pound, that's 16 ounces. So if we have a box that weighs 7 pounds, so from 0 to 7, so that's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 pounds. Now, it takes 2 boxes to equal a pound, all right? Because it says 8 ounces. A box weighs 8 ounces, and a pound is 16 ounces. So that means there's 8 ounces, there's 8 ounces, 2. So that's 16. Another 8, another 8, another 8, another 8, another 8, another 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8. So each one of these humps is 8 ounces. So 2 boxes equals a pound. Another 2 boxes equals a pound. So all together we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So another way to do it is 7 times 2 is 14. So there are 14 boxes in the shipment. And that wraps up 4th grade Module 7, Lesson 4, Solving Multiplicative Comparison Word Problems. And if you want more help with your mathematics, go ahead to embark.online. Go to that website and you got a lot more stuff.